We're joined by Tom Farley now. He's the president of the New York Stock Exchange, and he is on the trading floor. Tom, it's great to see you. I know you guys have been working so hard in anticipation of this. It's really unprecedented. How do you feel things are going so far?
They're going very well. It's not unprecedented in the sense that we have a lot of IPOs coming to market. This is our 87th IPO of the year. We've had several multi-billion dollar IPOs already. It's unprecedented in the sheer scale. Certainly, it has the potential to be the largest IPO ever, and it is actually the most highly valued company ever to list their stock anywhere on any exchange in the world. But I feel good. We've been testing and preparing much like we would for any IPO, and the market's functioning as it should so far this morning.
Okay, terrific. And there is a lot, as we were hearing, a lot of orders to get through, so we know that the timing can be anywhere in the next hour or so. It's fantastic to see so many people on the floor, so much enthusiasm, but it doesn't really work if it happens every so often. How do you build on the momentum? This was a big win for you. You wrestled this away from the NASDAQ, from the Hong Kong Exchange. How does the NYSE keep the momentum going now?
Well, first and foremost, we keep doing what we're doing. We have a hard-earned reputation for executing for companies on the day that they list their stock. And then next week it continues. We actually have two more billion-dollar-plus IPOs scheduled for next week, and many more IPOs over the next 3 weeks scheduled as well. So first and foremost, we need to keep doing what we're doing, executing, doing a good job for companies. And I'll also mention, we also want to keep capturing global market share. Alibaba, obviously a global company. Mobileye, a few weeks ago, is an Israeli company. And next week we have Grupo Aval, the largest Colombian bank.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you that. Is this the beginning of what we could see as a more international flavor at the New York Stock Exchange? And what is your pitch when you're going after these international companies who have a great interest in many times of listing in their home countries?
Yeah, I think so. I do think this is it's a trend that has been going on for some time, but it's picking up pace, and that's largely because the world is so interconnected and the economy is global and not jurisdictional or regional. And our pitch is simple. We're the New York Stock Exchange. It's the greatest collection of companies anywhere in the world. Here in the United States, you have access to the deepest liquidity pool in the entire world. Companies have an experience here on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange that's second to none in terms of getting their message out to the right target audience. And so that's our pitch.
Yeah, one question, Tom. You feel you could bend the rules too much to let them on, though?
Poppy, will you repeat the question? Sorry, there's quite a buzz behind me.
Did you bend the rules too much? Did you bend the rules too much to let Alibaba list there?
Oh, did we bend the rules to let Alibaba list? Was that the question?
Yes.
Sorry, yes. Poppy, the audio's cutting out. I'm going to go ahead and answer that question. Alibaba meets our strict governance standards, the SEC's strict governance standards. I can tell you the lens through which I view Alibaba's operations is the experience I've had working with them in preparation for this IPO, their selection process, their process in putting together and orchestrating this day today, their roadshow was very deliberative, very well run, and very well governed.